First of all, every time you play Hometown, it's different than any other show.
All right, would you please welcome home, Rush!
We're in Massey Hall. We're on the stage at the classic music hall of Toronto. It's hard to know what the objective world view of Massey Hall is, but I would think it's our version of the Royal Albert Hall or something like that. I remember him coming here to see the bands that I loved. My favorite trio, Cream, were going to play Toronto, and I was so excited, and somehow or another, I could not get any of my pals as excited about it as I was. So I said, well, I'm going down to Massey Hall. In those days, there was no Ticketmaster, none of that. Went down to the box office, and that was exciting. So I bought one ticket. I was sitting right up by that pole. And you know, in those days, when your heroes came on stage, they didn't even walk. They kind of floated onto the stage. I was just, you know, staring, especially at Jack Bruce, because he was one of my first bass playing heroes. And I just couldn't get my eyes off his whole routine and how he sang, played the bass. And I remember that there was only two microphones on the stage, and they were going through the PA system of Massey Hall instead of having their own PA system. And so you got this distorted voice of Jack Bruce and Eric Clapton singing while they were just rocking the joint. Well, Massey Hall was the pinnacle prestige gig to us. To me, this building represented musical success.
Respect,
yeah,
right.
Yeah, exactly. Like, virtuosity, yeah. And it was a prestige building. So the idea of playing Massey Hall was the unattainable dream of every young player, because of the fact that the rep for this place was musical. First time we played, I think we opened here in 75 for Nazareth. And then we played a gig, I think later that year, after Fly By Night had come out, headlining it, which was just unthinkable. Suddenly there were all these live albums being made. Humble Pie had put out this big double record live album. It was a huge success. We said, well, let's do a live album, because that seems to be the thing du jour, right? So we did three nights here. We tried to recreate the feeling of being at the Rush show.
Yeah.
We'd never done a live album before, so we really did not know what we were doing. A crazy, crazy three nights here. Really exciting, totally nerve-wracking. We were not to be dealt with. We were all completely anxious. Still to this day, a lot of fans think it's their favorite Rush live album. It's certainly the most raw album we've ever made. When you live in a city, those buildings are iconic to you. You know? Massey Hall is a very, very significant building in my life in terms of the music that I grew up on and coming here to see the bands that I loved. And also in my career, it was a pivotal moment the day we got to play this building.